Hello everyone, my name is Iana Komarnytska, and in this video I will give you some tips on how to negotiate your work in restaurants. So if you're a ballet dancer who are interested in performing in restaurants and other local gigs in your area, it's very important to know what things to pay attention, what traps to avoid, and what mistakes to avoid. And in this video, I'm gonna share you specifically about some things that you need to pay attention in your negotiation process with restaurant owners or managers about your professional performances there. But I also want to bring your attention that negotiating gigs with restaurant managers is different than negotiating gigs with private clients for weddings or birthdays. So if you're interested in general in developing your ballet dance career for local events, don't forget to check my full course, business course for ballet dancers, everything about gigs that will include both topics. And in fact, the video that you're about to see is one of the lectures from that course, but it's just one out of 111 lectures that the course includes. So the link will be in the description to this video. Check it out and you will find a lot more detailed information on all aspects: restaurant gigs, performing at weddings, working with different communities, how to do contracts, business cards, your promotion, how to structure your show, which is now not just one or two dances, but actually 15, 20 or 30 minute program, and many, many more other useful tips that I really shared all my trade secrets about this industry or this field of ballet dance world. So good luck with your professional journey. Enjoy this video, don't forget to like it and subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also don't forget to check useful link in the description to this video. One of the important type of your clients will be or is maybe already restaurants. And if restaurant is hiring you for a one-time event, it can be their event, like they doing a Moroccan theme night or New Year party or something like that, but it's like one gig that they first like performance that they are inviting you to perform, then in this case it goes under the category of one-time clients. It's not anything, there is no anything special that you need to do for restaurants. And very often they will try to sell you on the thought like, oh, come perform, give us discount, and we will invite you to perform on a regular basis, or potentially we will consider that. Of course, there is a chance that they will hire you, but again, make sure that you're not given any discounts, especially on a highly in demand night like New Year party, and then suddenly then for any other clients you may even charge more because it's in like peak season and you will have a lot of requests, and then suddenly you will give discount to restaurant for the promise of potentially being hired on a regular basis. Don't do that kind of mistake. If it's a first gig or without right away commitment to do it regularly, or just like one gig, it's a regular price, it's a regular kind of negotiation, and that's it. And I had several situations that I was hired by a restaurant to do a special like one night show with an invited singer. They were doing like monthly special nights for their audience, and they invited me first, and it was regularly paid gig. And after that, they actually invited me to perform on a regular basis. So then, of course, we negotiated different terms. But make sure that whenever it's restaurant inviting you, you are protecting your rights, you're protecting your time and energy. And if it's a one-time show, it's a negotiation with one-time client, potentially that may have further collaboration. Also, restaurants can hire on behalf of their clients. So they're hosting a wedding for someone and they are contacting because bride and groom ask them if they can find a ballet dancer. So the manager of restaurant hires you. So in this case, again, it's not them at the end will be paying you money, although maybe you are dealing with everything through them. They're inviting you not even for their event, they wanted you for private party. And this is something very
for you important to differentiate and understand. Even if you are dancing in restaurant on a regular basis, dancing in the same restaurant for private event, it's a different thing. And you need to be clear and talk through with manager or restaurant owner what is the deal and how it's gonna be happening in this case. Because for private events, it's not really the restaurant paying you from their pocket. So for you, it's really less reasons why would you give a discounted price. Because private party, it's a one-time event, even if it's happening at the same restaurant. So now moving into actually performing and collaborating with restaurants on a regular basis. And we'll come back to a couple of the points that I mentioned just now to go deeper and clarify what kind of scenarios can happen. But whenever you are entering the restaurant scene, and if it's the restaurant that never had ballet dance shows before, you kind of have an open space to negotiate what works for you and what will work for them, and set up basically your own rules dealing with the restaurant manager or owner. But if you're entering in the restaurant that already has existing ballet dance shows, either with one dancer like that they have now, and now they're looking for substitute for whatever reason, or a rotation of dancers, you need to understand several important things. First of all, if a restaurant provides you a regular job, weekly, biweekly, even monthly, the payment per show will be less than what you get from private clients for a one-time event. And that's typical and that's normal, because they guarantee, they provide you ongoing performance. So you know for sure that once per week you will have that gig, or once per month. Of course, once per month and once per week will be different. Like once, if you're performing once per month, it still will be higher, the payment per show, if you're performing once per week, but it will be lower than just one-time event somewhere or even in the same restaurant. At the same time, always keeping back on the mind that you need to have a minimum rate, minimum price that you are ready to go and perform in the restaurant. So just because they start now providing you shows every day or twice per day, it doesn't mean you need to agree to perform for literally nothing, because it still will be your time to prepare makeup, to prepare hair, to get to the restaurant, to do a costume check, to do a program and update program at least from time to time, if not frequently, to do physical activity of actually performing, coming back home, dealing with unpacking, washing your face, dealing with soreness, etc. So make sure that even if they provide you super regular job, which is like always exciting and cool, but you're not lowering your payment super low, because with time you just get frustrated, like, why I spent my whole afternoon just for this, regardless if it has like maybe you have a daily show. So always feel what is appropriate for you, and it can be like varied. You see your situation, you see the restaurant with whom you work, you see the price range in your city too, like what is happening, so you have something to also compare with, and you decide for your own. But don't think that you need to start performing almost for free just because restaurant starts promising you or indeed offering you like a daily shows. It's lower than a one-time show, but it still needs to stay reasonable for you. So along with the fact that rates are lower typically than the one-time shows, another important thing to understand that if it's a restaurant that already has ongoing shows with ballet dancers, they already have a certain set of rules set up. And in this case, for you, it's either to agree with those rules or not agree with those rules. There is no point in being sad or frustrated or like etc. Like the restaurant, it's their business. They have rights to set up the rules, and they apparently found the dancers that work for these rules, even if you may be unhappy with them. So for them, it's already working. And now it's decision for you to either agree and enter their rotation and respect the rules and follow those rules, or disagree and just go and find some other restaurant or not work in restaurants in general, like whatever works better for you. But they will have already pricing that they will pay dancers. They will have the times of the show. They will have set up duration of the show. All these things that you need to be aware of and make sure, it's very important, make sure that those rules, they apply to all dancers. It's not something that they especially come in for you saying, oh, this is our rules. So the price, it's the same price for all dancers. If they start telling you like, oh, but you're just starting beginning at our restaurant, so firstly, you will have a low payment and then with time you increase. Okay, if you know, if you talk to other dancers and this system applies to everyone, again, this is their rules. And then for you, it's either to agree or not agree. But make sure it's not a new rule that now applies to you, but all other dancers were receiving like normal payment right from the beginning. Same happens with trial periods. I know, I never personal experience, but I know some restaurants, they invite dancers to all come perform for free. We take a look and then we'll decide if we start working with you on a regular basis or not. With trial periods or trial shows, I have conflicting feelings, but again, I will come back to the same idea. Make sure that, first of all, make sure that this rule applies to everyone who was hired in the restaurant. So if that all dancers went through this trial show, trial period, okay, this is the rule that this restaurant has, and it's either for you to take it or not to take it. But also make sure that people were actually hired after those trial show. So it's not a restaurant is trying to get a bunch of free shows for their audience, not to pay dancers and not to have any commitments for further collaboration. Make sure that you also securing your rights and your work, your efforts, and especially like you don't really know those people. So there has to be, of course, like some level of human trust, but at the same time, if something is kind of bothering you, like, oh, like, always check if that's kind of rule applied to everyone. Also, in terms of working with restaurants, you need as a dancer, if they didn't tell you right away, but you as a dancer need to clarify and make sure you know a certain questions. Certain information about shows at the restaurants. First, it's what is the structure and duration of the show? So do they do like 20-minute show? Is it half an hour? Is it like a performance and an interactive part? Is it like, what is the style? Anything you kind of like need to make sure that your program, whenever you bring your music, fits whatever program or style they are having. Of course, you will have something individual with your interpretation of it, but within the structure of whatever is set up there. Make sure what is happening is interaction with the audience. Is it just a performance and you don't interact, or you actually can interact, or if for them it's important that you actually do interact. Just three different levels of communication dealing with audience members. So make sure what is happening there. Check also what is happening with tips. If accepting tips is appropriate there. Is it just your tips? Or is it, do you need to share tips among all dancers? Some restaurants require you to share tips. It's kind of unspoken rule, but better to speak through it, but to share tips with musicians. If you're performing in a restaurant, there is live band. So whatever tips happen during your show, you split them with musicians. So make sure you know the percentage, whatever is going to split, how you collect those tips. Maybe you can negotiate, ask some waiters to help you if people like throwing tips, like doing a money shower on you so you don't collect them from the floor. Again, see what is already working in the restaurant, how other dancers deal with these things. know what is happening, and then follow like whatever already happened, or clarify what is not clear from the information you get. With tips, I also want to bring your attention, be very, very careful whenever a restaurant requires you to share tips with restaurant itself. It's one thing to share tips with other dancers, your colleagues, whenever you're doing a group show. And the group show very often in restaurant means that you're doing your solo shows, but at the same time. So one dancer works with this group of audience, part of the like room, another dancers was this another group of audience, then they switch. So it's not like a group stage show, you're doing the same choreography. No, you're just dancing to the same music at the same time, but you're doing your own thing. And for restaurants, it can happen very like it's common. Sometimes they have a very strange like setup of the venue layout, so there's no way that all audience can see the dancer at the same time. That's why they kind of want to have several dancers, so there is something dynamic happening within that half an hour at any corner of their venue. There may be different reasons why they may have more than just one dancer per show. So this is also some information to you to find out. But regarding tips, it's one thing to share tips with other dancers who performed basically a group show. It's also one thing to share with musicians with whom basically you were creating this show. But it's another thing than the restaurant owner or the restaurant itself ask you to share tips. And this is something for you to be aware, because if restaurant is offering you really low payment, and then they want you to also share, request from you to share your tips with them specifically, they are trying to cover their expenses, those kind of tips. And it's very, like, for you to decide, like, to take it or not, it's your personal decision, and it happens on individual basis. Depends on the restaurant, depends on the atmosphere, depends what communication personality the manager or owner, restaurant owner has, if it's their set of rules, like with all dancers like this. But whenever it's this situation, be alert that if not right away, but there is a risk, there is a chance that with time, the restaurant management, or the restaurant owner will start put pressure on you that basically all you need to do is transform your show into going and collecting the tips, because they will expect you to cover their expenses with those tips. And this is not a nice situation, because first of all, will influence the quality of your show, that you don't have freedom what to do and how to do it. And then basically it will transform you into a person who dances for tips. And this kind of pressure, it's one of the most unpleasant, because it will spoil not only your joy from the show itself, but also your communication and your relationship with manager, owner, and or restaurant owner or restaurant manager. So whenever you see the rule, sharing tips with restaurant itself, not with other artists, or like giving gratitude to like a waiter who helped you maybe to collect tips from the floor, so you don't need to do it. It's one thing to share these kind of things. But with restaurant, just be aware. And first of all, check if that rule applies to all dancers and what is happening there. Second, like make decision for yourself, like if you're okay with it or if you're not okay with it, then deal with it another way. With all that said, yes, the restaurant, they typically will have a set up rules if it's an active restaurant with ballet dance show. But at the same time, it does not mean that you don't have any power to negotiate and to discuss details and possibly do some adjustments. I had one situation that I was invited to perform at the restaurant. I was doing from time to time some sub gigs there. They had the one dancer who was working on a regular basis, and then they needed some other dancer to switch to start working also on a regular basis. And they knew me from a couple of occasions before, so they invited me. But it happened, I discovered that on one of the nights that they were also inviting me to perform, they did not pay the previous dancer because the tips were so high that she was getting like really like way higher payment than what they wanted. And it was their rule that worked for many years. And I don't know if it's just with one dancer or these dancers who worked there even before her. I don't know. But for me personally, it was something unacceptable. Although I knew it would be very good tips on that day, but still, like for me, it was a firm, like, no, I don't perform for tips. I don't perform unpaid from the restaurant. So we still need to negotiate some base rate that I know whenever I'm coming, I'm paid this much. Tips is a bonus. Sometimes it can happen, sometimes not. And what basically happened for a month, it was like back and forth. They wanted me to hire me, but they didn't want me to pay because it's like, oh, but we did not pay the previous dancer. That was their argument. And that can happen with you too, whenever you're negotiating some details with the restaurant. Oh, but for other dancers, we do it this way. If there is something unacceptable for you, you don't be shy or uncomfortable to tell that and insist like, no, I would love to collaborate, but if you will collaborate, I need this thing. Can be payment, can be something else, like doesn't matter. But whichever element is really important for you, don't be shy to insist on it. And at the end, after months of like back and forth communication, they actually hired me and they actually paid me. So this is example of, even if we have rules, if there is something really important for you that bugs you, like you don't want to accept, you don't feel pressured to accept. And just go and focus on something else. There are many performance opportunities in your city. So even if that restaurant doesn't hire you, you still can be a successful ballet dance performer, solo ballet dance performer. So don't feel that you need to press on yourself and not go against your beliefs or what you want to do. And last note, whenever you're negotiating with a restaurant to start working there, make sure that the person who you are talking to is actually in charge of dance shows on like daily basis. To make sure that whatever you discussed with like one person is actually gonna happen and not that you will start working and then another person who actually is in charge will tell you, oh, but we work differently. And the classic example, for instance, that I have of the situation, I was negotiating with a restaurant owner to start performing at their place. And they were telling me, oh, we have shows on a daily basis. We can give you a lot of like work. So my negotiation was coming from the place like, oh, I will have like not daily necessarily, but 3-4 times per week shows at this place. And I was coming from this perspective on all the tests. And then I start performing there and I was like, wait, but you are scheduling me only once per week. What is going on? And then I discovered that the person who is dealing with dancers is actually a different manager who schedules all the dancers, and she actually has a system that applied to all dancers that whenever it's a new dancer, you first get like less gigs, like once per week, and then with time she starts scheduling you more and more often. So the more like mature or experienced dancers, specifically in this restaurant, not about our dance levels, but their experience specifically in this restaurant, they will have more gigs per week. And that rule applied to everyone. And then we start talking. She's like, I understand, but it would be unfair for me to do exception for you, because to other dancers, this rule applied. And now we're like, so it was basically at the end of the day, it was basically my mistake not to make sure, not to clarify, and not to talk to with a person or even do this first negotiation already together with the person who is actually in charge and dealing with dances and scheduling on all these like nuances. And then I basically got in a situation that I expected one thing and I received another thing. So for you, it's a precaution whenever you negotiate, always ask just, oh, but who is like scheduling or dealing with dances on a like day-to-day, show-to-show basis, and make sure that the most important like things, details that you discussed and arranged on, you also talk through them with this person to make sure that everyone is on the same page.
I hope you enjoyed this video and took a lot of useful tips for yourself. So don't forget to like it, comment below what was the most interesting aspect of it for you, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. As well as don't forget that I have actually the full business course for ballet dancers, everything about gigs that includes 110 lectures with 34 hours of content, and the link is in the description to this video, so definitely check it out, because if you like this video and watch till the very end, I really think you may find very helpful the entire course, so check it out.